Processing files is one of the most common tasks to perform in an integration. You'll probably use an FTP adapter to move the files in and out of the integration, but then you're going to need to process those files. Incoming files need to be read. Before that, they may need to be unzipped, unencrypted, or both. Outgoing files are going to need to be written, and maybe encrypted, zipped, or both. It's a stage file action that's going to let you complete those steps. Let's take a look at a couple of sample uses of the stage file action. In this integration, we use an FTP connection to bring in a file and unzip it. Once the zip file is available, we use the stage file action three times. First to read each incoming file, then after some processing to write each outgoing file, and finally to add those outgoing files to a zip file. At that point, we'll use another FTP connection and send the zip file onto its target destination. To add our first stage file action, we drag and drop the stage file icon and add it to the integration flow. When we select the operation we want it to perform, our choices include the ability to read or write files, to zip or unzip files, and to encrypt or decrypt files. For our example, we choose read entire file. We need to enter the file and directory information in an XSLT compatible format, so we open the expression builder. Inside the builder, we have access to XSLT functions and operators and to the actual XSLT expression we're building. But we also have access to the variables and the values that are available in the integration. And that's exactly what we need in this case. That lets us reference the name of the unzipped file without knowing that name in advance. Next, we specify the directory name, and we use the same technique to do it. We also need to describe the layout of the file. To do that, we'll point to a sample file that uses that same format. And now that we've described the format, we provide a name for the record set and the individual records within the file. And now we've configured our stage file action to read a file. Within the integration, we're going to do some manipulation of the contents of those files, and then we're going to write the modified records to new files. To do that writing, we add a second stage file to the integration. The integration is processing each record in the file using a for each loop, so we put the stage file inside the loop to write the records to the file one at a time. Configuring the stage file action this time includes selecting the write file operation and supplying the names of the output file and the target directory. Remember, we're processing the records one at a time in a loop, so we also specify to append each record to the current file. And then, just like with the read file operation, that last step is to describe the format of the output file. That's two down and one to go. Our third stage file action will zip up those new output files we just created. This step's only going to happen once, so we add the action outside the for each loop. And then we supply the configuration information again, the action, the source directory, the target directory, and the output file name. Since we're zipping up existing files, there's no need to describe the file format this time. In other conversations, we'll talk more about the other elements in this integration, the for each loops we used, and the FTP connections that comprise the endpoints of the integration. But for now, we can see that the stage file actions have done a lot of the work in the integration. They've read the incoming files, they've written the outgoing files, and they zip those outgoing files into a single file to be sent by the FTP connection.